Hi, everyone. Here I am, face to face with Caligula's horse, but not Inchi Tatus. I really know very little about this band other than the three little descriptive phrases that Vlad gave me, and that's pretty typical of my experience right now. So I'm just ready to dive in and see what I find. So let's get started. Here we go. What did you say this was? Progressive metal? Is that the... Make sure I'm on the right track. So, I've heard a few metal songs till now, and I haven't really thought of them as being particularly melodic. But this intro line is so singable. And it's pretty. It almost sounds... There were parts of it that sounded a bit like maybe bagpipes music or something. Just a hint. That kind of melodic line. Let's go on.
We're looking away for the weary hands to learn. It's too late, but I'm spinning and I'm run dirt. What do you want from me? Faint heart, tip off my tongue. Soul like youth wasted all day young. And it's over, over. What kind of father could I be?
This is really jumping around a bit. We started with this very beautiful melodic line at the opening, but then when the voice actually came in, there was hardly anything melodic about it. It was more just kind of, I don't know what... I'm trying to think of a word and I can't think of it right now. All I can think of is reciting, but it's not reciting. It's kind of pushing it, shouting it, but it wasn't really that loud at first. And now we're into this next part where, again, there's not a ton of melody. There's a lot of rhythm happening here. So, okay, let's keep going. There's that thing.
naked in the world.
Yeah, this is bouncing around a lot.
Is it protesting that you were looking for?
No, it was some descriptor of the style, and all I could think of was rap, but it's not rap. There's another spoken word type style, but I can't think of what I want to say. I have the lyrics here, and I'm not quite sure what to make of the lyrics yet. I'll need to study them to figure out what it's saying. But it feels to me like this music is kind of painting this dramatic background to whatever's going on in this lyrical story, picture, scene. And it's throwing us from one emotion to another state. And we went through this very powerful, almost violent in a way, expression here, and the percussion was really heavy, and then suddenly we're to this piano, which seems to be a little bit of a peaceful moment, or maybe a switch to a reflective state of mind, or anyway, let's go on and see what I find next. Really looks, feels like we turned to take a different angle on this picture. Setting those words. Time that I've heard the voice singing with this little melodic figure that I heard at the introduction. They made us wait all the way until here. Let's see, what time? I don't have the timing on this. I don't know exactly where I am here, but it's been a while. We went through, what, two verses already? Three verses, something? And finally, we hear this melody in a recognizable way that was first introduced at the introduction. And I guess that's the... I was kind of waiting for it. I was hoping for it, actually, because I felt like the music was bouncing from one to the next to the next. And I was curious to see if there was a way that it would come back around and wrap it all together musically. And here it is in this voice. So we hear the guitar stating it again, It kind of built up. It's actually a nice little sequence. So I'm going to back up a bit more and let's listen to it happen. There it is. The whole chorus of instruments, but you still hear that melody singing, kind of decorating. There's the voice. Interesting. That portion of the music there made me think of a group, I guess you could probably call it a band, that one of my students brought to me several years ago and said, I love this music and I want to learn to play one. So I listened to it and it was something I wasn't very familiar with. I actually still have the recording because I kind of go to it every once in a while. I wouldn't call it anything profound or deep, but it's called Celtic Thunder. And they do it in a sort of modern Celtic style. I guess you could say it's kind of rock-like in some ways because they have drum percussion in it. And in this section of the song here, I was hearing the same style that I heard in one of their songs that the student brought to me. So maybe that's where they fall in this. And maybe I'll be shocked. Maybe I'm shocked. Maybe I actually have listened to some rock music before. I don't know enough about the classifications, but anyway, I'll put a link to that maybe in the in-depth part, which is coming. Another video after this, so watch out for that, and be sure to click the link right here, because I'll talk about that when I dig into the musical elements some more. All right, let's go on. This part.
Fear.
to the hard stuff. Right there, where he was saying, the wound that would not heal, the boy, the broken wheel, the lion. I've heard something similar to that little phrase before. I don't know where it is. I'll have to see if I can recall it. But I see this song is quite long, and there's a lot that I could dig into. So I'll have to choose which elements I want to spend time on in depth. But I just wanted to say, something there I've heard somewhere. Maybe it's just a melodic fragment. Maybe it's a string of words. I don't know if it's something in poetry that I heard or if it's something musical. We'll see if I get back to it. But I noticed it. Section that just passed, again, it's the section that reminds me of Celtic Thunder, and there's something about it, I don't know what it is, that makes me feel like it's a sort of manifesto or kind of a celebration, an affirmation. It's almost patriotic in a way, but without being identified with anything other than we are. It's interesting. Anyway. that little melody. We're almost at the end of this song, and I'm so intrigued by the way it changes. It kind of jumps from one thing to the other. I have something to say about that, but I'll save it for the end, and I'll dig more into it in the second half, which, again, the link is here. And also, I want to say that what I do in the second half of it, where I dig into a bit of the elements of the music to try to explain and share with you why I hear what I do and what the music is doing. I'm also putting a music theory course for beginners on my Ko-fi page. So you might be interested in checking out the memberships there and see if anything interests you. But I want to finish this. I want to save the word that's in my mind until I get to the very, very end of this song. Because I have a word that came up about halfway through in my mind and some other ideas, but I'm going to get through the song first. To end it. Interesting. So, the word that comes to mind when I'm listening to this whole song, it's long, it has a lot of different things in it, one after the other after the other. And in some ways, it feels a little bit like it could be disjointed, almost like some of the sections are patched in there. But then as I'm listening, I'm noticing elements that are holding the music together, one section to the next. I need to explore this music a bit more deeply before I say this. I don't even know if it's the same genre of music, because I can't remember what Nightwish was called, but the sections remind me of the sections that I heard in Nightwish. I don't mean that in any disparaging way, but it reminds me of that organization of the music, where it feels like it's supposed to be telling a story, and I feel like this story here is being told in a rather in a very epic manner, dramatic, powerful, and at the same time, we're hearing different episodes of the story, or maybe not even episodes. Maybe we're looking at different elements within a story in each section. And I could say that it doesn't quite hold together, but I don't think that's true. I think it does hold together for the most part, and it does feel like one continuous piece of music that belongs there. But what I'm fascinated by is how this music is really quite long. And from my classical background, I have this sort of expectation that when music lasts a while, the composer usually develops or expands on a certain musical idea. And I'm discovering that that's not so common in rock music. And in fact, one of the episodes coming up with my rock history with Amy and Carl, he touches on that. How that is really not how rock music is constructed or conceived. There are other elements, other ways that the creators use to build up this music. And so I'm not saying it in a way that means, at least right now, I'm not saying it in a way that means it's lacking something. I'm simply saying I'm noticing this, and it intrigues me. I'm curious about it, and I'm curious to dig into this music a bit more and see what I find and discover about how the different elements are brought together and do support the entire work. But I guess I would say there are parts of this that I thought were really beautiful. There were parts of it that are more aggressive than the style of music that I tend towards personally. I wouldn't say any of them were really horrible. And maybe as I work a bit more on understanding the piece and I begin to dig into it more, I will appreciate those parts more as well. I feel like I need to pay attention to the lyrics, because it seems like the lyrics and the music are meant to go together. So I just, you know, I had them both here. This was my first exposure, and it's going to take me a few days, but I will come back and tell you what I've discovered and my impressions after I've spent a bit of time with it. So there we are. That's my first listen to this Graves. And I have to say, I am a bit relieved that it's not like At the Graves. I think one At the Graves is enough for me in my life. It's part of my continuing experience, and I'm eager to spend a few days with it. Before I go, remember that I have a poll on the community page here on YouTube, and it's a chance for you to check out, to contribute to my listening experience by voting for what song I'm going to feature as a community vote next month. So do check it out. Please give your vote, and then after you've voted for the band, do drop in the comments the name of the song from that band that you want me to hear, because I'm looking forward to that too next month. I'll see you soon.